ജീവൻമുക്തിപ്രദം ദേവം ക്ഷമാപൂർണം ജഗദ്ഗുരും വന്ദേ പരമഹംസാഖ്യം നിത്യാനന്ദായ സ്വാഗതം. ജീവൻമുക്തിപ്രദം ദേവം ക്ഷമാപൂർണം ജഗദ്ഗുരും വന്ദേ പരമഹംസാഖ്യം നിത്യാനന്ദായ സ്വാഗതം. ആനന്ദാനുഭവാസ്വാദം സർവരോഗനിവാരകം വന്ദേ പാപവിനാശക്തം നിത്യാനന്ദായ സ്വാഗതം. ആനന്ദാനുഭവാസ്വാദം സർവരോഗനിവാരകം വന്ദേ പാപവിനാശക്തം നിത്യാനന്ദായ സ്വാഗതം. നിത്യമുക്തം നിർവികൽപം ധ്യാനലോകപ്രദീപകം.
പരമഹംസ നിത്യാനന്ദരു നമ്മ യുഗദ ഒബ്ബ അഭൂതപൂർവ ആധ്യാത്മിക ശക്തി. ಅಂತಾರಾಷ್ಟ್ರೀಯ ಆಧ್ಯಾತ್ಮಿಕ ಸಮಾಜದ ಆಂದೋಲನದ ಸಂಸ್ಥಾಪಕರು, ಆಧುನಿಕ ವೈದಿಕ ನವೋದಯದ ಪ್ರಥಮ ಅನ್ವೇಷಕ, ಪವಿತ್ರ ಊರಾದ ತಿರುವಣ್ಣಾಮಲೈನಲ್ಲಿ ಜನ್ಮ ತಾಳಿದ ಒಬ್ಬ ಯೋಗಿ, ಕೆಚ್ಚೆದೆಯ ಆಧ್ಯಾತ್ಮಿಕ ಸಂಶೋಧಕ, ದೈವಶಕ್ತಿಯ ಮಾರ್ಗದರ್ಶಕ ಜ್ಯೋತಿ, ಪರಮಹಂಸ ನಿತ್ಯಾನಂದರು ಇಂದು ಪ್ರಾಚೀನ ರಹಸ್ಯಾರ್ಥ ಯೋಗ ವಿಜ್ಞಾನದ ಪಥದಲ್ಲಿರುವ ಲಕ್ಷಾಂತರ ನಿಪುಣರಿಗೆ ಸ್ಫೂರ್ತಿದಾಯಕರಾಗಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಆಧ್ಯಾತ್ಮಿಕತೆಯ ವಿಜ್ಞಾನದ ಸಂಶೋಧನಾಕಾರ, ಆತ್ಮ ಸಾಕ್ಷಾತ್ಕಾರ ತೋರುವ ಗುರುಗಳು, ಅವರ ವಿವೇಕದ ಸಂಪತ್ತು, ಅವರ ನಗುವಿನ ಆ ಸಂತಸ ಹಾಗೂ ಅವರ ಅದ್ವಿತೀಯ ದೀಕ್ಷೆಯ ಶಕ್ತಿಯನ್ನು ಪ್ರತಿ ವರ್ಷ ಪರಮಹಂಸ ನಿತ್ಯಾನಂದರು ಪ್ರಪಂಚದಾದ್ಯಂತ ಸುಮಾರು 1 ಕೋಟಿ ಜನರೊಡನೆ ಹಂಚಿಕೊಳ್ಳುತ್ತಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಈಗ ಪರಮಹಂಸ ನಿತ್ಯಾನಂದರು ಜೀವನ್ಮುಕ್ತಿಯ ಬಗ್ಗೆ, ಆನಂದಮಯ ಜೀವನಕ್ಕಾಗಿ ಪರಿಹಾರಗಳ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಮಾತನಾಡಲಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಮರೆಯಲಾರದ ಆಧ್ಯಾತ್ಮಿಕ ಅನುಭವವನ್ನು ಕೈಗೊಳ್ಳೋಣ, ಬನ್ನಿ.
Even if I gain a thriving kingdom that has no rival on this earth, and even lordship over the gods, I surely do not see how that can destroy this deep anguish that is parching my sense organs. Wow. First time Arjuna is talking intelligently. The moment you surrender, the first thing happens to you. The moment you become disciple, you find the right problem. Understand? Till now, Arjuna was talking different problems. All are his engrams, not real problems. The moment he said, I am your disciple, he is talking about real problem. I think the power of the engram over Arjuna has mellowed down. Till you are experiencing the sufferings because of engram, you will not find the original suffering. Here, Arjuna finds right problem. He is not stuck with engram-based problems. He is coming to the true problem. As long as you are suffering with engram-based problems, you cannot experience, catch, understanding the real problem, what Arjuna is now going through. See, he is telling, he is suddenly looking beyond. Even if I give this whole kingdom and Lord of the gods, Krishna, I don't see the anguish parching my sense organs. He realized the suffering has no reason. As long as you associate some reason for your suffering, you are misguided. you are running in the wrong direction. You have not diagnosed yourself properly. When you understand there is no reason for suffering, is your existence is suffering to express your existence to your existence. It is like you are suppressed inside you, and the suppressed you is trying his best to break free from that suppression and express itself to you. Suffering is not due to some reason. All your effort to find some reasons for suffering is only you yourself trying to miss the real life. Suddenly Arjuna is realizing his sufferings are not due to any reason. Whether he wins or loses, even if he wins and gets control over all the worlds and gods, he feels, how is the anguish that is parching? My sense organs are going to be healed. He realizes the original suffering. When you start suffering and trying to identify some engrams, some reason for the suffering, if you did not find the reason, you are blessed. Then you will realize suffering has no reason. It has no reason. Your existence is suffering. The cosmic existence is suffering to express its existence through your existence. It's like a child trying to come out of mother's womb. The enlightenment is trying to come out of you. When a mother who is delivering a baby tries to find any reason for her pain or suffering, if she feels, oh, maybe I hit my hand yesterday, that is why I am having suffering. Okay, that can be reason for the pain you feel in your fingers. What about the reason for the pain you feel in your leg? Because when you are delivering a baby, your whole body is going to experience that agony, that anguish. What about the pain you feel in your head? Maybe you can say, no, I was hitting my head so hard on the bed, that is why I am feeling. Okay, what about the pain you are feeling in your stomach?
ಕಲ್ಪತರು ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮದಲ್ಲಿ ಕುಂಡಲಿನಿ ಜಾಗೃತಿಯ ಶಕ್ತಿಯನ್ನು ಕಂಡುಕೊಳ್ಳಿ. ಕುಂಡಲಿನಿ ಎಂದರೇನು? ಪ್ರತಿಯೊಬ್ಬ ಮನುಷ್ಯನಲ್ಲೂ ಸುಪ್ತವಾಗಿ ಅಡಗಿರುವ ಅಸಾಧಾರಣ ಸಾಮರ್ಥ್ಯವೇ ಕುಂಡಲಿನಿ ಶಕ್ತಿ. ಒಬ್ಬ ಜ್ಞಾನ ಗುರುಗಳ ದೀಕ್ಷೆಯಿಂದ ಈ ಕುಂಡಲಿನಿ ಶಕ್ತಿಯನ್ನು ಜಾಗೃತಗೊಳಿಸಬಹುದು. ಒಮ್ಮೆ ಕುಂಡಲಿನಿ ಶಕ್ತಿ ಜಾಗೃತಗೊಂಡರೆ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಜೀವನದ ಪ್ರತಿ ಕ್ಷೇತ್ರಗಳಲ್ಲೂ ಪರಿವರ್ತನೆ ತರುವ ಶಕ್ತಿ ಅದಕ್ಕಿದೆ. ಹಾಗೂ ಅದು ನಿಮಗೆ ಆರೋಗ್ಯ, ಸಂಪತ್ತು, ಯಶಸ್ಸು, ಸಂತೋಷಭರಿತ ಸಂಬಂಧಗಳು ಮತ್ತು ಆಧ್ಯಾತ್ಮಿಕ ಜ್ಞಾನೋದಯವನ್ನು ತಂದುಕೊಡುತ್ತದೆ. ಧ್ಯಾನ ಹಾಗೂ ದೀಕ್ಷೆಗಳ ಶಕ್ತಿಯ ಬಳಕೆಯನ್ನು ಕಂಡುಕೊಳ್ಳಿ. ಕುಂಡಲಿನಿ ಜಾಗೃತಿಯ ಒಂದು ಇಳುಕು ನೋಟವನ್ನು ಕಲ್ಪತರು ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮದಲ್ಲಿ ಅನುಭವಿಸಿ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಭವಿಷ್ಯವನ್ನು ರೂಪಿಸಿಕೊಳ್ಳಿ. ಪ್ರತಿ ವಾರಾಂತ್ಯದಲ್ಲಿ ಸ್ಥಳ ನಿತ್ಯಾನಂದ ಧ್ಯಾನಪೀಠ, ನಿತ್ಯಾನಂದ ನಗರ, ಬಿಡದಿ, ಬೆಂಗಳೂರು.
Going to carry that anguish, that suffering is going to be there. If you try to find any reason for your suffering, you will take revenge on that reason. Taking revenge on the wrong reasons continuously is what I call birth and death. If you wrongly identify your husband as a reason for your anguish, you will start taking revenge on him. Somebody asked me, Swamiji, why do so many women want same husband for next life also? I said, maybe they don't want to waste the time they took for training him. The time they spent training him in one life. Why waste training period? If you find your boss as a reason for your suffering, again and again you will take birth to take revenge on him. If you find your relationships as a reason for your suffering, you'll again and again take birth to take revenge on them. If you find human society as the reason for your suffering, you'll again and again take birth and become a terrorist to take revenge on them. Incarnation is almost like a 10,000 year old soul. I'll call a soul as a soul when it has become an independent awakening energy, like a Pratyagatma Chaitanya Jagrata. Now any incident happens in front of his life, he collects only the lesson from that. From Chennai, one doctor, she was telling me, in front of our house there's a beautiful tree, Parijata tree. These corporation fellows were trying to dig drainage, and in that they were about to damage the tree. The roots were getting exposed, and she was really mad at the corporation contractor, and he called them and told them to put the pipe in front of her house to save the roots of the tree and finish the job in front of her house. And that contractor could have done it within 5 minutes because all the machineries were there, but just to get some money out of her, our devotee, that fellow was just playing this game and that game. No, I was busy. I am busy with this work, that work. And he did not do it. She said that tremendous anger it came. The anguish, suffering happened in her. She says, because she did not identify any reason for that anguish, she did not curse him. She says, suddenly the whole anguish, anger, suffering turned as an energy into Anandaganda. The whole energy moved up. She said, I was witnessing and suddenly I felt tremendous energy in my Anandaganda, and I sat, closed my eyes, did not shout at him, did not do anything. In 10 minutes, the fellow was so angry and against, came with the machinery and did the job and went away. I told her, now the Pratyagatma Chaitanya Jagrata has happened in her. Means, without you involving, your thoughts are becoming reality. Without your false identification, without your false cognizance and actions. See, if she has taken cognizance that this contractor is responsible for her suffering, anguish, it's a false cognizance based on the engrams, samskara. She did not take cognizance. She just allowed the energy to explode, raise with a witnessing awareness, consciousness, and she is really a sincere person. When your experiences become reality, emotions become reality, without you taking wrong cognizance and wrong actions due to the wrong cognizance, you are already having Pratyagatma Chaitanya Jagrata, the individual soul awakening, the inner awakening has happened. Now, from now, see, actually from the day she had that experience, her birthday of the soul starts, the count starts. Now, any number of years she lives with that same mood, she will only pick up wisdom from every incident. Means she only gets matured from that day. Her life, I can say the age of the soul starts. See, till that moment, only her age of the body, that is not in any way useful because it is going to die.
Kalpataru, uttama aarogyada aashirvadavannu kandukolli, anarogyada moola kaaranavannu alisi haaki, nimma chaitanyada mattavannu 1300% ಹೆಚ್ಚಿಸಿಕೊಳ್ಳಿ. ಅದ್ವಿತೀಯ ಅವತಾರ ಪುರುಷರಾದ ಪರಮಹಂಸ ನಿತ್ಯಾನಂದರಿಂದ ವೈಯಕ್ತಿಕವಾಗಿ ಆಶೀರ್ವದಿಸಲ್ಪಟ್ಟ ಒಂದು ದಿನದ ಪರಿವರ್ತನಾಕಾರಕ ಹಾಗೂ ಉಪಶಮನಕಾರಕವಾದ ಒಂದು ಅನನ್ಯ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮ ಧ್ಯಾನ ಹಾಗೂ ದೀಕ್ಷೆಗಳ ಶಕ್ತಿಯ ಬಳಕೆಯನ್ನು ಕಂಡುಕೊಂಡು ಕುಂಡಲಿನಿ ಜಾಗೃತಗೊಳ್ಳುವಿಕೆಯ ಒಂದು ಇರುಪು ನೋಟದಿಂದ ಶಾಶ್ವತವಾದ ದೈಹಿಕ ಹಾಗೂ ಮಾನಸಿಕ ಪರಿವರ್ತನೆಯನ್ನು ಅನುಭವಿಸಿ ಉತ್ತಮ ಆರೋಗ್ಯಕ್ಕೆ ಮೊದಲನೆಯ ಹೆಜ್ಜೆಯನ್ನು ತೆಗೆದುಕೊಳ್ಳಿ. ಕಲ್ಪತರು, ನಿಮ್ಮ ಭವಿಷ್ಯವನ್ನು ರೂಪಿಸಿಕೊಳ್ಳಿ. ಪ್ರತಿ ವಾರಾಂತ್ಯದಲ್ಲಿ ಸ್ಥಳ ನಿತ್ಯಾನಂದ ಧ್ಯಾನಪೀಠ, ನಿತ್ಯಾನಂದ ನಗರ, ಬಿಡದಿ, ಬೆಂಗಳೂರು.
like even if she has lived 100 life, that all the years she spent in that 100 life is not going to be counted. That is not going to be the maturity of her soul. But the day she had this experience where, see, anybody would have naturally associated with that contractor only, they are suffering. They would have called another one contractor and did the job. She did not do wrong cognizance. She did not find reason for her suffering. And she is really honest. That is the reason. The suffering has immediately raised itself to the level of Anandaganda and becomes answer, become reality. I can tell you, the whole Bhagavad Gita, Krishna does just this one job. Removing the idea somebody is responsible for Arjuna's suffering from Arjuna and making Arjuna take right cognizance, stopping him taking the wrong cognizance. You see, if Arjuna takes cognizance that somebody is responsible for his suffering, like all the people, friends who are standing in front of him, or the Krishna who is asking him to wage the war, or blaming himself who has taken all the foolish vows in front of public, I will kill all these fellows, I will kill Karna, I will do this, I will do that. These are the vows Arjuna took in front of public. So now either he has to keep up that vow or live in a defamed way. So naturally he will try to blame himself. Please understand, even blaming yourself is wrong cognizance. The whole Gita, Krishna does only one job. Telling Arjuna not to take wrong cognizance and letting Arjuna's suffering remain as original suffering and evolve itself to its Anandaganda so that just action happens. It becomes reality without Arjuna taking wrong cognizance. When she had this experience with that government contractor, not taking cognizance of any reason for suffering and allowing it to raise itself to the next level so that it can become a reality by itself. If it becomes a maturity, at least for 5 years, 5 years is a too long period. If she can retain that state again and again and again for next 5 years, it is unlosable. You can't lose it. It's permanent. Because 5 years is a long period for any habit to become your biomemory. In the first level, it will be only in the level of muscle memory. But within 5 years, it will become biomemory. I can say, based on this scale, an incarnation soul is at least 10,000 years matured. When you stop taking cognizance of any particular reason for your suffering, the maturity of the soul starts. The dark night of the soul starts. The dark night of the soul should not be understood in a wrong way. Please understand, it's a tremendous depression filling your whole being, but should not be taken in the wrong sense. It is like a delivery pain. Delivery pain should not be taken as inauspicious. It's an auspicious experience to bring one more life to planet Earth. Same way, the dark night of the soul is the auspicious expression to bring one more enlightened being to the planet Earth. The day you experience the dark night of the soul, the maturity of the soul starts. With our example, I'll describe from now onwards. Any incident happens in her life, she will not collect 10 grams from her life. She will collect only the wisdom from that incident. Now, what has happened to her, you know? Now, suddenly a nerve in her is opened, which knows the alchemy of converting your suffering into action. that Nehru only I call it as Medanadi. When your suffering becomes automatically the right action,
because 2000 crore loss.
To reach at least 1 lakh people per day. Cognizance of, even if you don't identify some person or situation as reason, without wrong cognizance, your suffering expressing itself as an right action. Arjuna's darkness of the soul, we can start counting. Arjuna's soul is getting matured. He says, even if everything is achieved, I don't see that I can remove the sorrow that burns my senses. I can remove the deep anguish that is parching my sense organs. Means he is realizing there is no reason externally for his suffering. He is realizing his wrong cognizance. And I wanted to leave you all with this one truth today. Stop taking wrong cognizance for your sufferings. Your existence is suffering till enlightenment, because the cosmic existence is struggling through your existence to express its existence. So don't take wrong cognizance. Your family is not responsible for your suffering. Your friends are not responsible for your suffering. Your enemies are not responsible for your suffering. Not even human society is responsible for your suffering. You are suffering because you are suffering. Cosmos is trying to express its existence through your existence. You are going through a delivery pain. Don't curse the nurse. Don't curse your husband who made you pregnant. Don't curse the bed. Don't curse the hospital who is taking care of you. And don't take wrong cognizance. Any incident, person, situation you take cognizance is wrong cognizance. If you take the wrong cognizance, poverty is reason for your suffering, you will run behind Lakshmi. If you take the wrong cognizance, ignorance is reason for your suffering, you will run behind knowledge. If you take the wrong cognizance, powerlessness is responsible for your suffering, you will run behind Durga, Kali, behind power. Here he says, even if I have lordship over all these gods, I don't think I can remove my suffering. He takes the right cognizance of his suffering. Not having enlightenment is the reason for his suffering. He realizes he is going through the dark night of the soul. A cell in the reproductive organ of a woman, if that cell takes cognizance during the delivery time, that nurse is responsible for my pain. It is wrong cognizance. That cell should know life is trying to express through itself. Now, sit, mull over, not having money, not having relationship, not having energy, are all wrong cognizances you take for your suffering. Contemplate on Arjuna. The suffering now Arjuna is having, worth having. But suffering Arjuna had till the last verse is not worth having. Only in the last verse he says, I am your disciple. Then suddenly he is having the right suffering. When you declare you are a disciple, first great thing will happen to you is you will have the right suffering. Don't think you will not have suffering. You will have the right suffering. Then right suffering is a suffering which brings all sufferings to end. But unfortunately, everybody expects the moment you declare yourself as disciple, all suffering will disappear. No. First, right suffering will happen. Only then sufferings can disappear.